next time by Eric Holmes, Brian Eichler. And the battle's at third. Trevor Bayne on the inside of pole sitter Chris Johnson. And just so much action back in the pack. It's fun to watch.
There is racing everywhere. Big Sellers trying to make it work in that Jigaloo car in the bottom. He's got the 9 of Augie Vidovich right behind him.
It's a whale of a battle for 14th position.
There's that 3, that black number 3 of Austin Dillon. And he's coming. His nose. He is coming.
Dillon's gained a couple of spots since the restart. The 18-year-old high school senior. Dick.
Jason Bowles has started on the outside of the front row, but he is dropping back and dropping back quickly. A few moments ago, the crew rushed to the wall as if they were going to change a tire. Bowles had just been on the radio saying he thought he had one going down, but he is still on the racetrack and it's not going well for him. He's still losing spots.
There's Bowles in the number 6. In the wall, hard, one car, turn 1.
There's Nick Lynch. He was in that heavy, heavy battle we were watching just a few moments ago.
That was a hard hit to the concrete. And you can see how the back of that car is folded right up. You know what? Looks like it's still tracking pretty straight.
Yeah, it does. It does. Wow. Maybe they can get that quarter panel beat down a little bit so it doesn't block that spoiler. See him on the outside. He's got Austin Dillon right behind him. Looks like he might. Let's see if they get down in turn number 1.
Oh, no, the 12.
Yeah,
he got with the 12.
On the outside of Antonio Perez, they made a little bit of contact, and it turned Nick around into the outside wall. There's another view. You see the contact's already made top of your screen. Nick makes some pretty hard contact with that left rear corner. But I believe, as you mentioned, I don't think it did anything to the wheels.
No.
So if they get that quarter panel beat down where it's not blocking that rear spoiler, he may be okay.
Lynch was running 18th at the time of the caution, the second one we've had tonight.
See Rockstar Beverage on the hood of that Dodge. Brother Scott doing the spotting for him here.
The whole family was out at Barrett Jackson last week.
Mm-hmm.
We were live on Speed and talked to Scott up on the block for a bit, but big family vacation.
Yeah,
really
that's
enjoy
right.
It.
Do it every year.
Coming down there. Second caution of the night. 29 of Nick Lynch making contact with Perez and into the turn 1 wall. Ready for the restart at Irwindale. And let me make a correction. The leader does not have lane choice on the restart. He must start inside the front row. That's where Eric Holmes is. Brian Eichler trying to take the lead away as we go back to green for lap 34.
And that's exactly how Eric Holmes wrested the lead away from Chris Johnson. Good battle right now. Eric Holmes fighting back on the inside. Trevor Bayne trying to take over that third spot from Chris Johnson, or hold off Chris Johnson, I should say.
Now Eichler should have the steam on the outside, and he clears the number 20. So Brian Eichler, your new leader. Eric Holmes in second. Here comes Bayne. Slotting into third and Johnson fourth.
Check out that guy now running fifth, Mike. That 33 car.
Ron Hornaday in fifth.
Ron started all the way back in the 13th spot.
That's that orange car of Hornaday.
Battling with the 46 of Jeff Barkshire. Jeff was a winner last year on the West Series.
Second place battle. Here comes the one on the bottom, Trevor Bayne.
Kids want to make this last ride in this DER I-car a good one.
Well, he's here for the audition. He's not sure for whom, but he wants to run this series this year or move up.
He's got the spot. Clears Eric Holmes to take over second.
That was kind of a contact clear, wasn't it? Just a little bit. Johnson in fourth, Hornaday fifth. Everybody involved in that first caution is okay. Those that did not return to the race have been released after a checkup. Oh, we were 5 wide in turn 4 for a second. And you don't see that here often. That's because the 12 is scrambling its way to the back of the field with problems. Antonio Perez.
Good side-by-side battle. That's Alex Haas. That's Kyle Busch's car on the inside, the black 51. See the 71 of Eddie McDonald. His family owns Lee Speedway back in New Hampshire. Eddie won last year in the East Series. Jason Bowles, the sixth car, right behind that battle. There's Mike David sneaking his nose in here with his Toyota.
Yep, the Bennett Lane Winery Toyota, champion of the West Series 2 years ago. And Sellers goes to the inside on David.
Boy, Peyton Sellers has big things coming for him this year. Going to run a limited nationwide schedule. Really excited about that. Todd Barrier is going to be involved with that program. RCR crew chief for Kevin Harvick. Ed Barrier, his cousin, probably going to be the crew chief, I believe, on that car.
Well, Sellers keeps trying. He can't get past Mike David. David snuggled up against the bumper of Jason Bowles.
Logano trying to take over the seventh spot from David Mayhew.
Joey Logano in the Joe Gibbs driven 08. And there is Antonio Perez. Jim, what's the problem?
Well, when you mentioned the five wide tussle in turn three, it was because Antonio Perez was checking up to not get in the back of Eric Richardson. Well, he did just that. The left front was rubbing on the tire. He came down pit road. They did not change any tires. This is a 12-tire race, so if it's not punctured or flat, they cannot change it or face a two-lap penalty per tire change. Again, only changing if the brakes is allowed, unless it's down or punctured. They're looking over the tire now, losing valuable time and getting that fender away from the left front of his Dodge.
All right, we'll have a look at a replay of what happened to Antonio Perez.
A little bit of contact right there, Logano and Mayhew.
So on the right of your screen, a little more than casual contact there.
It certainly was. Well, look at him, three wide underneath those guys. Matt Kobluk goes through the middle.
Yeah, Kobluk made a great move in the middle of traffic there.
Along with Alex Kennedy in the 37 car.
This is the seventh place race. Just ahead of them, they're side by side as Hornaday tries to hold.
Oh, trouble.
41 on the wall. Ryan Foster. Here, caution.
Ryan was running in the 14th position. See a lot of sparks coming out from underneath that car. He makes his way onto pit road. He's actually going behind the wall into the garage area.
Foster from Anderson, California, the Glen Haven Resort Sport brings out the third caution of the night. 47 laps complete. Welcome back to the NASCAR Toyota All-Star Showdown. Third caution flag of the night, Ryan Foster up and into the wall. And a number of drivers, including Mark Davis, taking the opportunity to pit. Jason Fensler is in, and Todd Souza making his second trip to pit road. Ryan Foster brought out this caution. Dick?
Well, he's out of the car, and he is a very unhappy young man. You haven't even looked at the right front. You know what happened?
Yeah, I mean, we blew a right front tire. It was going down about, 10 laps into it. I made a couple of runs there towards the front, and then it started fading pretty bad. And then right there on the last lap, it started vibrating a little bit. I didn't quite know if it was a left rear or right front, but obviously it was the right front. It just sucks for my guys, you know. We work really hard, and I'm the one that fixes this thing at home, so it makes it even harder on me. But I got to thank Glen Haven Beach Resort, Hollis, and everybody that helps me on after hours on this thing.
Tough luck. Better luck next time. Jim Trado.
E-Series champion Matt Kobluk is radioing in, hey, I'm in 17th. We're at lap 50. This car is taking way too long to come in, so he wants to make some changes at the break of lap 100 to get this car a bit freer. He wants to add more bar. He said, right now, I can only run the outside line. His crew chief, Perry Waite, said, we'll fix it at lap 100, but it's way too long to come in. So Kobluk complaining the car's not working just right, and they'll make the adjustment.
Brian Eichter, the leader. Trevor Bayne alongside Eric Holmes. Johnson in the second row, Hornaday, Berkshire, Mayhew, Logano, McDonald, and Haas are your top 10. We go back.